Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. This is Irfan Fazlullah, Senior Director of Marketing Partnerships and Strategy at Vonage. I have the pleasure of being your host again today. As a lot of you know, we started moving this webinar to a weekly cadence roughly about 4 weeks ago in response to the challenging times that we entered into and continue to be in. And we are all hopeful that the situation gets better. But we have been really overwhelmed by the amount of feedback and participation that we saw from you. So a special thanks to all of you who are here with us today, and particularly to those, a lot of you are here with us for the fourth straight week in a row. So I hope that as in the previous weeks, you will continue to find today's webinar as helpful in helping you stay ahead of the demand that we are seeing a lot and the necessity that we are seeing from a lot of our customers across the regions. Today, we are going to be talking about how we can enable you to innovate the contact center with custom built solutions from Salesforce and Vonage. We'll take a look at the advantages of a complete tech stack and what it means to deliver value for the contact center needs of our customers, especially in this environment, and the advantages of a contact center built into Salesforce. As most of you know, Salesforce is one of the world's leading CRMs and the leading contact center solution for service teams. And the great part is that Vonage has been a key partner and ally of Salesforce from a contact center, from a service and sales cloud perspective. But particularly on the service center side, we are kind of purpose built to deliver value from an omni-channel intelligent lead routing and analytical perspective for contact centers to intelligently operate their needs from in any environment, especially in a virtual environment, as is the case for many of the customer businesses that rely for business continuity on their contact centers. So we are hopeful that you will both relate to and appreciate some of the capabilities that we'll walk you through today. And as always, please feel free to ask any questions using the Q&A panel. We will have a Q&A session at the end. And joining us today to kind of take a deep dive into the world of contact centers with Salesforce and Vonage is John Flynn. John is our principal contact center sales engineer and brings over a very rich 35 years of contact center experience to our sales team. He has a very deep knowledge of the contact center space, being a certified Salesforce administrator, a Salesforce Trailhead Ranger, with as many as 140 completed badges. He's someone who really lives and breathes driving value for Vonage customers, Vonage and our partners' customers in the Salesforce ecosystem, particularly when it comes to contact centers. So over the last 4 years, he's been working very closely on our contact center product, and is now also a critical member of our channel and alliance teams, and has already started working with some of our largest master agents and a lot of our key partners, as some of you may know, on enablement and education initiatives. So with that, again, as a reminder, please continue to, any questions that you have, please submit them using the Q&A panel. And with that, I'll hand this over to John. John.
Thank you, Irfan. That was a great introduction. I look forward to spending the next 50 minutes or so going over some of the deep capabilities provided by the Vonage Contact Center and how we have unparalleled integration into Salesforce. Before we jump into that, just to kind of level set, Vonage has really changed the dynamic in terms of communication platforms. We really have created now the most flexible cloud-based communication platform, and that really rests upon three main pillars. We're going to take you into the contact center pillar today in a deep dive, but we also have a set of capabilities enabled by our communication APIs, primarily our Nexmo and TalkBox portfolios, as well as a full unified communication stack with our Vonage Business Cloud communication. So we'll spend a lot of time today on the contact center space, primarily through our tight integration to Salesforce. Some of you may know us priorly as New Voice Media, but now all those capabilities are tightly integrated into the Vonage communication stack. So we'll talk a bit today in some of our demo scenarios about integration into Service Cloud, how we can do dynamic routing. We'll show a couple different examples of that. we can really operate on any of the fields and objects within Salesforce. Those could be custom objects and fields as well as the standard objects and fields. We'll touch a bit upon omnichannel and the way that we can integrate multiple ways to Salesforce for omnichannel, a bit about interaction analytics, field service lightning integration. We will not be able to show you the Sales Cloud today, but we do have a full integration for automated dialing, integration to Salesforce high velocity sales. So there's a lot of capability. We'll spend most of our time on the inbound service applications today. And we'll finish up with some Einstein Analytics. We really do have a rich set of capabilities enabled through our conversation analyzer. And then Einstein Analytics is a perfect way to consume that very robust set of data. So we're going to show you how that looks. In terms of why people spend their time with Vonage in the contact center, we are one of the top 25 ISB partners with Salesforce, recently achieved summit status. That's the top 1% of all partners in the ecosystem. We have been working with Salesforce for over 13 years, have over 740 customer reviews, and all of them were certainly the highest, the majority of them skewing to very satisfied customer ratings. We have closing in on now 900 global customers with Salesforce. So we understand this space. We focus on it exclusively with the contact center offering, and we're able to offer a deeper integration because of that focus. In terms of what we'll talk about, Service Cloud, omnichannel routing, and the ability to operate with custom objects, whether you're enabling chat or email channels, other channels within Salesforce, the ability to seamlessly route those calls with your voice calls to the same agents. We'll show some of what that looks like. In terms of some of the rich conversational analytics provided by Conversation Analyzer and Einstein, once we place some of those calls, we'll look at the resulting records and the reports that we can create from them. Lastly, I think I want to take you through a demo where we'll actually show the voice of the customer. Because we have the ability to integrate voice response capabilities into the Vonage Contact Center, after callers are completed, it's very easy to route them to a voice-driven survey. You can then deposit those results into Salesforce automatically and use that to influence how you may route calls, maybe kick off a workflow if it was a bad survey, all kinds of things that you can do with that integration. So we'll talk about and touch on all of those things. In terms of what we're going to see here today in the demo scenarios, I'm going to start with some inbound customer routing scenarios. The Vonage Contact Center has a set of capabilities that typically people who operate contact centers are looking for. So very advanced call routing capabilities, skills-based routing, a lot of announcement flexibility, and the ability to allow customers to direct themselves through prompts if you want to interject that. An integrated dialer if you need to do a lot of outbound dialing where that can be more automated. A full set of call recordings and speech analytics and dashboards. So we'll touch on that. The real magic being the deep integration with Salesforce and the fact that we can operate on any custom field, any custom object within that universe to influence call routing, to influence how that customer is handled. In terms of how we can deliver the phone calls or the voice calls to your agents, the system is very flexible in how you can do that. Every agent comes with an included soft phone license, which is leveraging WebRTC. And in essence, you just need a USB or Bluetooth headset, plug into your PC, and that's how you would deliver your phone calls. Some customers want to have physical phone sets or have physical locations and phone sets that they want to leverage. Any direct dial phone, PBX phone, could be that target, what we call a landing number. When an agent logs into the contact pad, they have the ability to put in a phone number and deliver phone calls to that set. Because of that capability, you could fully leverage mobile workers, home office workers. This is very topical given our current environment where everybody is now working remotely. Many of our contact center agents really have not been impacted because they can seamlessly make that transition. So I'm going to jump into our demo environment here. Second here, we got to pause the screen share to get into our demo environment. Okay, So we now jumped into an instance of Salesforce Service Cloud Console. We do support all of the different views, versions of Salesforce, Classic, Classic Console, Lightning, or what's called Lightning Console, which is the view that I am in here. Agents have the ability to log into the Vonage Contact Center through single sign-on or through standard login and password combinations. We're going to surface several items on this lower utility bar when we integrate our managed package into Salesforce. That managed package is a very complete offering that includes several custom objects, many custom fields, visual force pages, a complete set of reports and dashboards. So it's a very deep and complete integration, as I've mentioned. Agents also have the ability to control their state or status through a configurable set of agent status codes or state codes. This allows you to capture activity that is non-phone related into the dashboards and reports that you're capturing. Of course, all the phone calls, all of the interactions that we will route will be properly accounted for and tracked, but there may be other activities, research, follow-up, creating campaigns, things of that nature that your folks will do, and you can capture that through creative use of these fields. Agents are also provided information across the contact pad. This is where agents would have visibility to that landing number. So I mentioned I might have the ability to present phone calls to a PBX or to a phone number of some sort. It's very easy for the agent to change those settings. So I've chosen here to use the soft phone, in essence, ignoring that telephone designation, but it's that easy for an agent to make that change. Information is also going to be provided when calls come into the agent. We'll typically pop open a record, which you're going to see momentarily. But in addition to or complementary to that record, information about the number the customer may have dialed to reach that agent queue, the queue that you delivered the call to, so that multi-skilled agent who may be handling a sales call and then a billing call and then a support call is given a heads up about the type of call they're about to receive. So we're going to leave this agent in an away state. I also mentioned this integration to Omnichannel, and you can see here that the Salesforce Omnichannel widget is indicating that I'm busy, and that's partly because the phone is also indicating I'm in an away or a non-ready state. Because of the integration, as soon as I make myself ready, you'll notice that the Omnichannel widget will change and make this person available for routing of any digital interactions that may be coming through my Salesforce environment. In this flavor of integration, this is called Omnichannel Presence Integration, Salesforce continues to route the digital interactions and Vonage will route the voice interactions, and we'll maintain close coordination so that we don't present an agent with two interactions at the same time. So as soon as they become either tied up with a transaction or unavailable, the other is informed so that we can coordinate that activity. So I'm going to leave this agent in an away state, and as we place these first phone calls in, I want to show you what happens when calls start to queue. I've also sent an email into our case queue, because I want to show you the ability of our Omnichannel where we're routing email to case in this particular example as well. So this particular agent is handling both emails and phone calls simultaneously for us. I'm going to get a phone call launched in, and you'll hear this momentarily. And we're going to introduce several choices to the caller so they can route their call.
You have reached the new voice media demonstration line. To discuss our great new products and services with your account manager, press 1. To speak to our award-winning customer excellence team, press 2. To access our self-service option, please press 3.
So I'm going to press 1 in this instance, and it's going to dynamically route to the personal queue of the account owner, who happens to be this agent.
All representatives are currently handling calls. Please remain on the line for the next available representative.
So this caller is now queuing, and there are several options that we are presenting to them while they're listening to music on hold. They have the option at any point in time to press 1, which will remove them from the queue and allow them to get a call back as soon as this agent becomes available for them. Or they could press 2 and leave a voicemail message. So depending upon the nature of their inquiry to us, they can decide to self-direct themselves if they don't want to stay in the queue. The other important thing is, because of the dynamic routing, we also know that this is one of our premier accounts. So not only did we look up on the phone number of who's calling, We also know that that person works for someone who's one of our premier accounts and deserves a premium service level. So as an agent, that's a heads up to me to make myself ready so that I can take this particular phone call. As soon as I make myself ready, we're going to pop open the record of the caller to that agent desktop. And we've also popped open the account into the background. So we have the ability to pop open multiple objects within Salesforce. And you can also see that we then made this window active and gave that agent that little bit of complimentary information, including the fact that this call waited for 58 seconds. So any queue time accumulated will also be communicated to the agent. Now, I don't need the contact pad open when I'm transacting with the call, so I can minimize that. I get the full real estate of however I've laid out my Salesforce environment. In this environment, we have surfaced up a handy notes section so that as you create the activity records, which will happen regardless of whether your agents enter any information or not, maybe this gentleman had a product question about the price, so I can make that notation. That will be saved with the activity record, making it more informative, more useful for you as a management team. You also have the ability to configure a set of call disposition or call reason codes. So these can be any definition you choose. We're always going to save the activity record to what we call the focus object, in this case, the contact that I popped open. But you also have a nice and handy ability to save the interaction to any other object within that Salesforce universe. So maybe the product that this person had a question about would be a logical association. So now statistically, I just have that much more visibility into the nature and the reason why people are calling and contacting us. I can save those notes at any point during or after the call. I have the ability while I'm on the call to pause that recording. So we do typically have the ability to turn on call recording. You can selectively turn that on or off within your call plans. And then you also have the ability to give agents the ability to pause and resume if you choose to. So you can either allow the system to control that, or you can allow your agents to also have the ability to pause and resume as they need to. Agents wanting to reach out to a supervisor, needing to transfer a call to another agent or queue or department, very easy to do so by hitting the consult button. You're automatically going to put the caller on hold and pop open a list that's going to give you all the pre-configured call plans within your system, all of the ACD queues that you've configured, and most importantly, all of the agents and their current state. So I know that Alex Taylor, I can see he is in an available state because of the green button. I can actually highlight him and hit dial. I'm not going to dial him right now because he's not expecting a phone call. But we would be connected. This box disappears and I get a set of soft keys, conference, transfer, release, and retrieve call that will allow me to work my way through that transaction to its conclusion. Now, the last thing I want to show you on this call is I start to wrap up with Jason. So I've done all of my note-taking. We've answered all of his questions. I'm about to release the call. And one of the things we have the ability to do is that voice-driven survey that I talked about in the very beginning. So as soon as the agent releases the call, I can direct him into an IVR-driven survey so we can capture his satisfaction right at the moment of, you know, having completed that phone call with us. So as I hit release, you'll hear this.
Thank you for participating in this short survey. Did we resolve your issue effectively the first time? For yes, press 1. For no, press 2.
So in this example, I'm going to say no. It'll be a bad survey.
On a scale from 0 to 10. How likely would you be to refer our services to a friend or colleague?
I'll say 3, not very likely.
Please leave any comments about your experience today after the tone.
The agent was untrained and not able to answer any of my detailed questions.
Thank you for your feedback. We hope to speak to you again soon.
So a couple things have happened. We've completed the phone call both from the agent perspective as soon as we hit the release button, and now from the caller perspective, having completed the survey. Prior to taking that survey, I was a happy customer. I was a net promoter, and I had a green satisfaction level. And as a matter of fact, as I mentioned, we can utilize any of the fields within Salesforce to influence our routing. And so we utilize some fields here. If everybody is happy, I play the normal set of choices and announcements to them. If it's an unhappy customer, I kick off a workflow in Salesforce to reach out to that customer. And the next time they call in, I play a different set of announcements apologizing for the bad interaction. So as I refresh this record here, you'll notice that we have updated the fields based on that most recent customer satisfaction survey that was just taken. And now we see that we have an unhappy customer. And if I went into the related list, I would find a custom object that we've created called a post-call survey. And you can see right here that it was a bad survey. If I want to, I can actually open up the survey. I could see what questions were asked and what the answers were. Now, this is a very brief survey, but you could customize this and it could be something very different if you wanted to. And then I have the ability to actually get down into the actual call recording for that survey. That usually takes a minute or two to post that, so that's why I don't have that available momentarily, but that would be available within 5 minutes for your agents. So now when I call back in again, I just want to close the loop. You'll hear that the announcements that gets played to this caller is now automatically different because of that bad survey.
You have reached the New Voice Media demonstration line. Discuss our great new product. We are sorry that you had a negative experience during your last call. We will transfer you to our escalation team.
And so the call, the call comes in. And because of that bad survey, I play that different announcement. I gave the call priority. I can even route it to a different set of agents. So just one example of the dynamic routing. There's another example where sometimes customers will say, we don't want to present an IVR choice to every one of our callers. We don't think that's the kind of customer experience we want. We have the ability by just changing the support level from standard to premium within the demo flow to remove the IVR choice. So a premium customer will just get routed into the agent and get a thank you message for being a premium customer. So again, just two quick examples of how you can utilize any field, any object within Salesforce to influence how you route the call, what announcements you play, what options are given to that caller, et cetera. I mentioned we create these activity records for each and every phone call, and we can take a look at the most recent one that we just had today. Each of them is constructed in a way to provide the baseline set of call metrics that are used to build the detailed dashboards and reports that we deposit in Salesforce. So this particular activity record gives me some information about the agent and where the caller was. If the agent entered a disposition, I'll get that detail and any notes, which is why I encourage agents to do so. We'll get to see who the caller was. And if there was a related second object, it could have been the account, it could have been a sales campaign, it could have been anything. It happened to be a product in this example. The call metadata about the call ring time, call duration, when it came in, and then this very nice link to the call recording player. So I actually have the ability to stream the call recording right from our secure cloud. And as I'm reviewing that within the Salesforce activity record as a manager, a coach, a supervisor, if I notice anything of importance, maybe I can make a note. This agent did a really good job opening that call. So I can make that notation here. And then also put a little visual indicator so that when I come back to this call at any point in time, I could jump right to that moment in the call. These comments will be saved with the activity record going forward as long as you store it within Salesforce. The example we have here is just some custom fields where we can actually create a quality monitoring scorecard, if you like, right on the activity record. So now that I have very handy access to the call recording, maybe I could do an official review of this agent's performance. And I can run a set of reports and what have you based on the way that these calls scored. So all those things are kind of part of the art of the possible with the integration into Salesforce. There really is so much customization you can do. You really have to define what it is you want to go off and accomplish. Now, I do want to take you in and look at a set of the dashboards and reports. I've got a dashboard up here on my home screen we could take a look at. Really, we create two different flavors of dashboards and reports. So we have a standard package, which has two pre-built dashboards that come out of the box and 13 pre-built reports, and then a more advanced package, which adds 5 additional pre-built dashboards and 44 additional reports. But the most important part is not the number of reports, it's how easy they are to work with and how integrated they are into your Salesforce environment. So as I go into the reports area, I'm going to pull up one of our most, I think it's actually our most basic report. And I do that for a reason. I think this is kind of our ugliest duckling. And I want to show how easy you can work with the tool and how easy it is to turn these reports into something that makes sense in your environment. So this calls made today report, one of our baseline reports, is really just a CDR list report. Beginning at 12 midnight, it will list in chronological order every inbound or outbound call it receives. There's no other organization, there's no grouping, there's very little useful information surfaced. And so I took 5 minutes with this report and turned it into a much more useful report that an agent, a manager, supervisor might look at in a contact center. So we added a quick graph in the report viewer, and that does two things. It allows me to look at the overall team and see my performance, but it also allows me to quickly find an agent and drill down right on that particular agent's record, and then I'll just get that particular agent's phone calls. We also then grouped all of the calls by agents, so they're no longer random. You don't have to go hunt for them. And then we added a bunch of field values that would help make sense of what these calls were about. So outbound calls don't have a name of an incoming line associated with them, but other inbound calls do. And so you can see what lines calls came in on, what the call outcome codes indicated by your agents would be, if it was related to any other objects, how long was that call, and very easy to further customize because of the tight integration with Salesforce. Really, all of our activity data is just a set of field values that sits right within the Salesforce database itself. And so if I wanted to add, say, a link to the call recording, I can just start to spell within that wizard. It's smart enough to bring any call fields that match the spelling. Call recording link was what I was looking for, because what I would like to do if I run this quick report change is I now have a very handy link to the call recordings right from the report itself. And maybe I have a set of executives or managers that I'd like to provide that capability for. So that's a baseline package. Now, one of the things that we also do in our advanced package is we create an additional activity record called a New Voice Media Call Summary Record. And in this particular record, this is the baseline both for our advanced reporting as well as the conversation analyzer, which is that ability to take all of the conversations, fully transcribe what is spoken about, and then look within the conversations for topics of discussion, business items of interest, things of that nature. And I'm going to take you in and show you what that looks like right now. So the advanced record is actually a second activity record that we create for the phone call, and it just has much more detail than that more basic activity record that I showed you. So you get this nice visual up top where you can kind of see what that caller went through. These are all the various different states and statuses. I can see that there were two agents involved. Eventually, the call was transferred to that second agent. As I flow through the record, I get a lot of detail about the call itself. I now have the ability to capture and accurately report on two separate agents who were involved in that phone call and accurately account for the amount of time that agent one versus agent two was handling the phone call. And then just a very robust set of call segmentation and detail that is really helpful and useful in driving change and understanding within the contact center. In addition to that, because Conversation Analyzer allows us to look for topics of conversation within the phone calls, there's a whole new set of fields that we created called Conversation Analyzer Analytics. And I'm going to show you in a moment the graphical view, but here's really the baseline metadata about the things that I noticed in this particular phone call and the amount of time that I saw various things. I can also see the percent of time that an agent was talking versus a customer versus any kind of silence or crosstalk or talkover analysis. So those are all very helpful metrics. But the real magic in Conversation Analyzer is really seeing and understanding what that customer journey was all about. So for each and every phone call, the ability to look at that overall journey through some key metrics, dynamically, the ability to hover and understand the amount of time that a customer may have been talking, or versus your agent versus any silence that may have existed. The ability to subject that call to a set of configurable filters that you define and would allow you to look for various things in your phone calls. In our little demo environment here, these are the things we look for in real world environments. These would likely be competitive mentions, requests for escalation, things of that nature. But whatever those happen to be, you have the ability to dynamically turn these categories on or off. So I'm going to just hide the subcategories for a moment. So let's assume I'm the compliance officer and all I care about is compliance events. I can very quickly and easily turn off these other filters and just look for the compliance events within my phone calls. And if this happens to be it, I can do, you know, very quickly do that and move on. If I'm the customer experience manager, maybe I want to understand the entire customer experience. As you find topics of conversation that you were looking for along the call timeline, they'll be surfaced here. You can see the significant call events, the separate call path for both the agent and the customer in terms of who is talking and when, the ability to listen to that call recording right from this interface, the ability to do the same kind of commenting that I showed on the prior older recording interface, and then most importantly, the ability to jump right into the actual call transcript. And any time that you found verbiage based on the color-coded categorization you had, you'll get the matching color-coded category all the way through the entire phone call. We then lastly take that entire call transcript all the way down at bottom of this very detailed record, put that entire call transcript in an additional Salesforce field so that you would have access to it for any other business use. So that's what we do for each and every phone call, and that's a great amount of insight. But there's also a lot to be learned when you look for the patterns and the trends that are beyond just what's revealed through an individual drill down to a specific phone call. So we have the ability to jump into Einstein Analytics. So because we've created this very complete, very complex, multidimensional call detail record, it's now very appropriate for an advanced analytics tool like Einstein to be able to consume that data and to be able to help you provide the insight that's provided by that. So if we jump into this dashboard, we'll take a look and see what we have to look at in terms of our call repository. So as of right now, we have like 640 random phone calls that are sitting in our call recording. They have all different combinations of both metadata attributes, you know, this agent handled them, they were handled by this queue, they came in on this line, as well as a number of different things that we noticed through conversation analyzers. So are we seeing effective communication? Are they asking leading questions and those types of things, effective question handling, things of that nature. And I can jump into either of those attributes at any point. So I can work through a set of managed filters within this Einstein dashboard, or I can jump right into some of the actual components of the dashboard itself to start to drill down and look at more of a subset of the calls instead of just the entire set of phone calls. So I'm looking for some sets of communication. I think I want to look and see if there's any, we've been getting some information, our complaints are not being handled properly. So as I start to drill down through this dashboard, and in this particular case, I got pretty lucky because I did two quick filters and was able to get from the 640 random calls to the two calls that were in my call repository that met those particular criteria, where I didn't see effective communication and I had a complaint. And so now I can drill down and see, well, you know, do I have, listen to that phone call, I could open that call record right from here and go right back down to that root cause analysis. So that's kind of a quick way where you can close the loop on understanding not only the trends that are going on at the very high level, but the ability to then very quickly drill down and go into a root cause analysis about why you may be seeing those trends within your center. The last thing I'd like to show you is I have really been doing kind of a pure agent experience at this point. And so what I want to do is show you what the back end of we had that phone call. Now, let me just want to hang up. I just want to go into the administrative, what we call the back end of the Vonage Contact Center, and show you a couple of the useful features and functions that people make use of in managing their center. In addition to the dashboards and the reports that we just showed you, which are historical by nature, meaning that the call has completed, I've written the activity record in the Salesforce, and I can now pull that record, you might want to have information about what is going on in your center as we speak. So what I'd like to do here is I'll get my agent. I want to make sure this agent's in a non-ready state. I'll just get a call in so we can show the dashboard lighting up, and then I can talk you through some of the detail of what that looks like. So we'll get this launched very quickly. And I can take you through kind of how you can create, customize, and clone these dashboards. So now that we've got the dashboard set up, we have this concept of building widgets. And widgets are the ability to say, I have a set of real-time data, things that are currently going on in my center right now that I would like to display. And I've got these set of widgets to display that data. So depending upon the nature and the way that I want to display the data, I would likely pick one of these widgets to do so. So in this case, we brought several different widgets to the dashboard. We've got a large number here. I've got a table. I've got a graph. We've got a little bit of a donut chart here. So I want to just show you what the widgets look like in terms of how easy they are and how intuitive they are to set up and manage. This is where you would jump into and get into the settings aspect. And all of them are structured roughly the same way, where you decide to say, what is it that you are looking at? So what metrics do you want to put up and look at in this? So I'm going to look at calls waiting, and I'm going to group the calls waiting by queue. Now I have this nice related filters list that says, okay, do you just want to look at one queue, two queues, all queues? And so in this particular case, I'm looking at all of the queues in the system. And the wizard is very easy to, you know, allow me to say, hey, I want to look at one or two queues. I could eliminate them and then just add in, you know, the two that I wanted. So it's very easy to work with the wizard. You also have this very nice capability on all of the elements to create visual thresholding. So if this data were to have more than two calls waiting, this bar would turn amber. And if it went to more than five, it would turn red. And so now the data on your dashboards turns color in real time based on the parameters that you've established for it. So it draws your attention to the things going on in your center that need your attention. So perhaps our 47% service level is something as a manager I need to staff up my agents for. I, you know, need to do some things to help change that before the day gets out of control. The other aspect where people spend most of their time will be in the creation of their call plans. And so we have this ability for each and every incoming phone line. You have the ability to create these various different demo flows and then display them with our visualization tool. So it kind of helps show some of what you're doing. We string what we call together these applets. Applets are unique capabilities within a call flow to do certain things. So this applet is turning on the call recording. So this is where it starts call recording. It checks for the hours of operation, and if it's normal business hours, it plays the normal welcome announcement. If it was outside of normal business hours, it would go to the closed announcement, and it would allow you to take a message. But as we flow through here, we start to show the real power of the way New Voice Media is integrated with Salesforce, because now I can do this very detailed and cascading set of queries within Salesforce to look for who this caller is, to update data, to create records, to really do whatever it is I may want to. So in this case, what I do want to show you is I'm saying I'm looking up into Salesforce. I'm either going to create a record, get Salesforce data, or update that data. And then I have the ability, as I mentioned, to look at any object within that universe. And I mean any object. And so these are all the different objects within this Salesforce instance. All of them are exposed, and then depending upon the object that you pull down in this list, it will help you pull back various field values. So if I wanted to pull back more than just the account contact owner ID and support level, I would would have the ability to do so because any of those fields are automatically exposed in my drop-down menus. So that's the depth of the integration and why this kind of power is so easy to bring into your call plans, because you really never get to a point of having to code. You really just do intelligent clicking and organizing of your call plans to create the types of customer experiences that you're wanting to. So with that, I think we are at about 40 minutes of. I might be a couple minutes early, but maybe there might be a couple of questions. So I will pause here and see if we have some questions from the group.
Thank you so much. That was fantastic. No matter how many times I see the demo, it never ceases to amaze me. It is always insightful and it's easy to see why we continue to be the number one rated CDI solution, the communication solution from a contact center standpoint on the Salesforce App Exchange. But again, I don't want anyone in this audience to take our word for it. I hope they are impressed enough with what they saw today, the capabilities. But I would encourage everyone to actually go to the Vonage Contact Center page on Salesforce App Exchange and read the glowing customer reviews, which in many cases painstakingly outline exactly why they are so in love with the contact center solution and the kind of results it has delivered for the companies. So again, thank you so much for this demo. Before we open up for the Q&A, I do want to kind of note a couple of points. In addition to all of the customization capabilities that you saw today, the fantastic intelligence and automation components that are so easy to add, all kind of designed with that one singular goal in mind, which is to drive up agent productivity and just drive ease of use and capture intelligence across all levels and in many different contexts. This solution especially is even more relevant in today's environment because an agent really does not have to be tied to their desk. This gives them not just the agent, but also the entire team, including the call center manager and the supervisor, the flexibility to run business as usual while maintaining the same level of efficiency and, most importantly, gaining the same level of insight as they would on an on-site solution, if not more. And to make it easier for a lot of the customers that are looking to kind of make that switch very quickly in this environment, we have put together a couple of offers that are designed around addressing that need, helping customers kind of quickly adapt this solution in a more flexible, scalable, and most importantly, cost efficient way. So I would encourage you to kind of go to, and John, if you can actually pull it up on the screen as well, vonage.com/solutions. We have a couple of offers on there for both business continuity in general on the UC side, but also on the contact center side. And one of them is the business continuity offer, where we are giving a 50% discount on up to 250 Vonage Contact Center Express licenses. Again, a great way to kind of get jump started without a very long term commitment. Again, the underlying goal here is to first and foremost address that customer need, and everything else comes afterwards. In the same vein, we also have a disaster recovery offer, where we are essentially giving companies the capability to set up a fully functional service cloud contact center and put it on standby, both from a short-term use perspective and the capability and just to pay as they use it at a discounted fee. But it is a special design for those companies that have had to quickly move to a virtual solution for their contact center and have invested a lot of money onto an on-prem contact center and are not sure for how long this crisis is going to continue, and especially if it's going to come in waves, to have the flexibility to, at least in the short term, to switch between those two solutions while they put together the mechanics and in terms of resources and funding and everything to fully deploy a virtual contact center for the long term. So these are, again, great offers. We're already seeing a lot of kind of great organic interest. A lot of you have been providing a lot of good positive feedback for it. So I would absolutely ask you to encourage you to kind of take advantage of these. Again, from a support perspective, in addition to these offers, we are also our PX360 team, which is our partner experience team, which consists of post-sale implementation teams, engineering teams, and partner program management teams, they have really come together in a very efficient way, very quickly to deliver on top of these offers, on top of these product and platform capabilities that are really easy to kind of deploy and adapt and use, to also quickly install these services in a very expedited fashion, in many cases within 48 hours or less. So one of the first questions, incidentally, that we got was about how do we set up a more in-depth demo for us or our customer? Do you want to take that?
Sure. Typically, I work very closely with our channel support manager, regional support manager structure for the channel. So best point of contact would be that RSM, that channel manager, and they have direct access to myself as well as other engineers, depending upon subject matter, depth and expertise you're looking for.
That's fantastic. One of the questions was really, will the session be recorded? Yes, this session is being recorded, and it'll be shared in a post event follow-up email to you later this week, but it is also available, as is the case with the previous three webinars, which we did on business continuity preparedness for channel partners, was the first one, and the second one was on the single pane of glass communication solution, what that means for our customers. And the third one was on the post-sale implementation capabilities and process, particularly in this environment. So every single webinar each week that we do, this is a weekly webinar. It happens at the same time at 12 noon Eastern. Every single one of them is available. The recording is being made available to every attendee and everyone who registered but was not able to attend. You can also get a copy of the recording on the portal eventually, and as well as from your regional channel manager. If you are new to this, to Vonage, and are unsure who your channel manager or salesperson is, you can always go to vonage.com/channel and find your local channel sales professional. So I'm just going to move to the next question in the queue. Can you select on a per seat basis what type of license the customers get? That is some UC, some CC, and various levels of CC licenses.
So I do know there is some license flexibility. I don't know if it's unlimited in terms, but I do know there'd be a subset of people who might just be UC. There might be a subset of people who are just CC. There might be another set of people who are a combination of both. And I know you can kind of do that easily within the licensing tiers.
Got it. No, that is helpful. Yeah, we can always, the sales and engineering team on the ground, we have a very integrated sales model that really puts our direct sales teams, which really are kind of the XMEs from a contact center standpoint, and a lot of them also have vertical expertise. So depending upon your opportunity and need, that team can come together very quickly on the ground to find the most ideal packaging, ideal solution, first and foremost, for what the customer needs and the most ideal way to kind of package the solution for the customer. So please, there's always a limitless number of ways in which things can be customized, and our team will work with you on the ground to make sure we're putting the best foot forward to deliver against the need. The next question is about, can you talk a bit more about integration between Omnichannel Console and CDI plugin? In addition to status, are there any other integrations possible?
Yes. So I did hint that there are multiple ways to integrate into Salesforce, and the presence integration is kind of the baseline level where each platform is checking with the other in real time to understand what that agent is doing. Most importantly, are they available or tied up? And each though remains responsible for routing transactions. Salesforce routes digital transactions, Vonage routes voice transactions. We also have an integration leveraging what Salesforce calls their external routing or third-party routing API. And in that model, Salesforce initiates the digital transaction, but instead of routing it themselves, their first action is to hand the interaction to us via an API call. At that point, it comes into our platform, and you now are subjecting that interaction to the very same set of routing rules that you are for your voice communication. So the whole vision is that you have a single brain routing all of your interactions. And of course, they route through the same queues to the same agents. You're just doing it through a single engine, not the coordinated use of two engines like you're doing in the presence integration model.
That's great. Thank you so much. The next question is really about custom objects. And again, that is one of the most high interest areas. We continue to see a lot of interest and kind of essentially curiosity as to how what kind of capabilities we have around that. So the question is really about, can you create custom objects in Salesforce using this integration? And how can you report on those objects?
It's a great question. And it does exploit one of the, I think, one of the key benefits of the way that our solution is built out, in that we have exploited the API to the extent that we can take advantage of any new custom, any object that exists, and any new custom objects or fields that you create. And once you've created those objects and fields, because they exist in that Salesforce ecosystem, they become available and reportable in the dashboards and reports that you're going to roll up. So it really does give you that complete set of visibility into all of your interactions, kind of that 360 degree view of your customer.
That's great. You may have covered this to a certain extent, but might be kind of just kind of quickly address that again. What are the two different ways to integrate with Omnichannel?
So the Omnichannel presence integration is the, I'll say, the easiest. It's a pretty low effort way to get, I'll say, 80% of the benefit out of that integration. And then the external routing API is the other way within Salesforce. The only caveat that I would at least make the group aware of is the external routing API from Salesforce only exposes the email and the chat channels currently, meaning if you had a desire to bring Facebook Messenger or other messaging platform inputs into your center, you would more likely want to go with presence integration, because their API currently doesn't support those channels. That makes sense.
In many ways, we are essentially able to, one of the value that we're adding there, even from a Salesforce adoption perspective, when it comes to Omnichannel, is we are able to come on top of those native components and truly kind of add more value from an Omnichannel context, right?
Correct.
One of our next questions is on call routing. And what are some of the ways that call routing can be affected?
So typically, the way the call routing gets affected is kind of in a multi-step process. First, you want to identify, if you can, who the caller is. So we have a very effective way of doing that. Most vendors will try to pass what's called the CLID, or the incoming calling line ID of that caller, into Salesforce and do a lookup. And that's successful a lot of the time, but it's not successful all the time. Many times you have callers that are calling in behind a number that's not theirs. It might be a business PBX or some other number, or sometimes you might have multiple matches. You might find that number exists in three or four records in Salesforce. So what do you do? We have the ability to conditionally say, only when we have those, non-single match scenarios, we could bring the caller to our integrated voice response very seamlessly, maybe prompt them for that identifying number. It could be the cell, it could be a mobile number, it could be some other account number. And we can then use that to do the lookup. Now we know who the caller is. Any of the data that we're maintaining about them in Salesforce can be used to route them. Do they have a certain value? They've bought, $10,000 worth of gear from us over the last years. Have they accumulated so many thousands of miles with us in a loyalty program? Whatever it is you're tracking about your customers in Salesforce, we can look at it and, based on values there, make rational decisions about, should I change the priority? Should I give them a different option? Should I route to a different group? Whatever, really the world is your oyster to some degree in that, what kind of experience you want to create. That's a long-winded answer. Apologize for that.
No. I think no amount of detail is too much when it comes to the complexity of deploying like an intelligent contact center solution. So thank you for that. The next question is really about, can we integrate this Vonage Contact Center solution for Salesforce with Health Cloud and FSC as well?
So yes, we can. Because of that depth of integration, we have the ability, in almost every case, to integrate into all the native clouds. I think the only exception is Marketing Cloud, and that's because it's structured a little bit differently. Salesforce actually acquired that from another company, and it doesn't quite fit the architecture of what they've done with some of the other things. But we found in almost every instance, people who have Marketing Cloud also have Sales Cloud. So we integrate with Sales Cloud, and we're off to the races there. We do integrate to HLS. We actually are building out short-term some demoing capabilities. Really, it's just, in most cases for Salesforce, it's just a collection of some new objects and fields and buttons and things that they put together and create this cloud. And so because we have this native capability to work with all kinds of custom objects and fields, these new clouds typically do not create a hurdle for us.
No, that's great. And this particular question also touched on a topic, which is an area that is a lot more than generating a lot more activity and a lot more interest, healthcare in general. It's a very broad category that includes everything from hospice setting solutions, infrastructure to telemedicine and telehealth to first responder services. So it's a very broad category, but overwhelmingly across this category, we have seen a lot of immediate interest and need just in this last 6 to 8 weeks from different perspectives. And incidentally, at this point, I just want to kind of take a moment to inform our audience about our next webinar, next Wednesday's webinar. It's going to be focused on healthcare with a particular focus on how we can help customers optimize patient care with triage solutions. And we're going to touch on the unique advantages of, again, our contact center solutions and the AI capabilities. There are, in addition to our core API engine, we have also kind of built a robust AI platform that then informs and makes our UCCC solutions and adds more intelligence to it in a more easier low-code, no-code fashion. But within healthcare, we are increasingly seeing the marriage of contact center and AI capabilities more than ever. So if healthcare is a topic of interest, or if you're looking to kind of grow that component of your business, or if you have customers within that vertical that are coming to you with a very specific need, either to kind of transform to a more of a virtual solution or to make the current solution more intelligent in these times, please be sure to tune in next week, 12 p.m. Eastern Time, 4 p.m. GMT. And I'm sure you will find this particular webinar as helpful as well. At this point, I mean, there's a couple of other questions I want to make sure I quickly get to it. We have a couple of more minutes. So one of the next questions that we have, John, is something that I think could be a quick answer. It's really about how do our partners get some demo accounts for the contact center solution?
Okay, so typically to actually run the demos themselves is a lot of times people will request that kind of access early on. And then as you get into the care and feeding of these demo accounts, which I live with every day, most people tend to back out and want an easier way to tell the story. So we've actually created a few assets for the partner community, at least to start that. And then for the people who really want serious access, we have the ability to, we can give them a demo account and get them trained up, assuming that they want to put the time and energy in doing that.
Got it. Within this particular solution, do we have the facility to capture and store missed calls?
Yes. So we do, you do need the advanced reports to do that because the standard activity records, the way they work within Salesforce is they'll only write and post to a completed call to, you know, an object. I have to complete a call to an agent to actually know that, you know, who that was. So the abandoned calls become challenging, but the advanced reports captures all of that. And we have a specific report that shows all the abandoned calls.
Got it. Just a couple of more minutes remaining. So, but I do want to hit on at least one couple of points. I'm going to combine those questions and really put you to the test in terms of how brief and quick you can be. So I'm going to ask you about the real-time dashboard and if there are number of limitations in terms of the number of dashboards that can be used at a single time, and if there are any pre-canned dashboards. That's one question. And the next question is about what kind of metrics are companies interested in when it, particularly when it comes to conversation analyzer.
So as part of our PS professional services implementation, they will get you started with an initial dashboard or two. We don't build out a whole portfolio, but it is a very easy to use tool. And the idea when we build out the initial one for you is kind of to teach you to fish so that you can do as many as you want. You can clone existing dashboards. You can have many of them created and in the background. but of course you're only going to have one up on your screen at any one point in time. They're typically meant for large screen TV displays and or supervisors or managers. We do have some environments where like every agent might have them on their desktop. The challenge is they're so visually engaging that at some point your agents are spending all their time on looking at dashboards and maybe not doing the things you're paying them to do. So, but there really are no practical limits. Now, if you had thousands of dashboards all operating in one location, we probably would look at tweaking the refresh rate on some of the components if we were seeing some traffic issues. But that's the only thing I could think of. We haven't seen any real issues with them.
Got it. And the conversation analyzer metrics?
Ask that question again, because I...
What kind of metrics are customers interested in when it comes to how they're using conversation analyzer?
Primarily conversation analyzer. They're using it for, I see competitive mentions a lot. So they want to know if their competitors are being mentioned in the phone calls, and also for escalation. So are they getting examples of asking for a manager, or I need escalation, or other ways that people can express unhappiness, which I won't get into on this call.
Right. I mean, some of the other metrics that overall companies try to drive within the contact center space is productivity, of course, which is, again, a very hard metric to measure, but it is measured in terms of call response times, how much of agent's time is freed up, and how quickly and efficiently calls are processed, et cetera, et cetera. So there's a lot of metrics that, you know, as we design the solutions, we can, you know, our team can showcase. We have a ton of use cases, ton of case studies and testimonials that you can find on our website, on our corporate YouTube handle, the Vonage YouTube handle, as well as, you know, there's a ton of data sheets on Service Cloud, Sales Cloud, and for Contact Center in general that you can access through the portal, through your channel managers. So please make sure that you take advantage of that and reach out to your teams, and our local teams on the ground will always kind of help you kind of make that part of your pitch as well as part of your review. So again, I think, sorry for going a little over, but these were some important questions, and there's a few more that we were not able to get to. You can always kind of reach out to us through the channel manager. And if you don't have one, you can go to vonage.com/channel to find your local channel sales manager. And the team will be more than happy to kind of sit down with you and dive and do more in-depth dive into the contact center world and address the needs that you're seeing in your markets. Please make sure that you're aware of the offers, that some of the offers that we spoke today related to the contact center world. You can find them again, as you're seeing them on the screen, on the vonage.com/solutions. And that's all we have time for today. I once again appreciate everyone for joining with us today, especially those that have been with us consistently for 4 weeks in a row. We truly appreciate you and your participation, and we'll continue to make this very meaningful, engaging, and helpful and relevant for you in the weeks to come. This has been a great way for us to stay engaged and connected, and we are working very hard to bring together topics and package them in a way in this 1 hour format every Wednesday that will be the best use of your time, and hopefully, you know, drive a lot of great follow-up conversations and help you connect the dots when it comes to the needs that you're seeing in the market. So if you have any suggestions, always feel free to write to us at channelpartners@vonage.com in terms of how we can make this better. We are totally dedicated and committed to supporting our partners and customers through this time. So again, thank you for joining with us today. Be safe, be well, and have a wonderful day.